You know, in many working environments, people are physically distributed. Now, it could be a large office, or it could be an office and a warehouse or something like that. And it's important to be able to find somebody quickly. And that's where group paging comes in. And in this video, we're going to show you how to do that.
Okay, so this is really a case of setting up a group paging service in TIPT Administration Portal. You identify what number you want to use as the paging group. So the pager, the originator of the page, will call that number. Mm-hmm. And then once it's active, they can speak into the phone just as a, you know, into the handset, just like normal. Yep. And they will effectively be broadcast out all of the participant targets in the paging group. All right. So in order to set up group paging, the first thing we need to do is go to the TIPT Administration Portal, and we select the group or the site in TIPT language for where we want the group paging to apply. So this is a site-by-site service. We then go down to services from the options menu, and you'll find there's a group paging advanced option. You click on that. Now, at the moment, we don't have any group pages for this site, yeah. So we're going to add one. Now, before you do this, you need to have an idea what number you want to use as the group paging number. This should be a spare number. Well, it has to be a spare number. So yeah. It's not assigned to a user already, mm-hmm. And it can be even deactivated. The service will make it active enough,
yes,
for it to work with the service.
Yep.
So our paging group ID, we'll call it this site paging. So that's the paging group ID. Now, it isn't unusual to put the actual phone number in there. The reason I haven't done that is because I want to make it very easy to identify.
Yep.
And then we can just repeat that. Now, I'm just repeating some of these just to make it easy. Mm-hmm. Okay, so at this point, what we have is a new paging group. I select that. I now have to assign the phone number that I'm going to use. And the drop-down box will only show me the free numbers.
Yep.
So that's why it's important you don't try to use a number that a user already has. We'll choose the top of our available range, mm-hmm. just to make it easy to remember. And now what we do, you can actually set your own announcement repository up, but we're happy to run with the defaults. Originators, these are the people who can call the number,
yes,
to issue a page.
Right.
Now,
so it may, as an example, it might be a front desk.
Correct.
It could be maybe the meeting organizer, could be the warehouse manager or something like that.
That's right. And you can be in both, mm-hmm. so that you hear the group pages that you don't originate. Now, I've narrowed down the search criteria to our site, otherwise it returns too many users.
Yes. So you're selecting Lou Chen to start off with, and Lou's our receptionist for this business.
That's right. And I'll choose a couple of others,
yep,
just to show that we can have a bit of a broad set of users. So I'll choose Charlie Malone, and I'll choose our executive and the exec's PA,
okay,
as well. So
right,
they're going to be the people who can initiate the page. Mm-hmm. And we add those to the initiation group or the originator group. We then go to targets. And for this one, we're just going to say that everybody at the site can be a target.
Right. But you could set this up so that it's warehouse only or level 5 only or something like that.
That's right. You could. So we'll just do our multiple select. I'm leaving some of the key system stuff out.
Sure.
Just for this demonstration. Add those. Apply. And okay, right. So at this point, we have effectively a basic working paging group. Now, there's one last tip. We assigned the number 62328320,
yes,
to this service, 03.
Yep.
Okay, in this particular case. If you dial that number, even from an internal handset, mm-hmm. you'll get a number unavailable.
Right. Okay, because you're dialing an external number.
Well,
to
ostensibly,
come back in.
Yes.
Yeah.
You need to use the short code.
All right. The extension only.
That's right. 8320.
That's a really important tip.
All right.
Okay. Well, Chris, why don't we give this a go? Now, if we were to use these phones as they are, we're going to get some feedback. So I'm going to ask you to take your laptop and your soft phone in this case, disappear into another room, and maybe give us a group page from somewhere else.
All right. Let's see how it goes.
Paging.
This is a demonstration of group paging.
You should be able to hear me now.
And there it is. That's another example of what you can do in the TIPT environment.